and you have influence. You people don't know the kind of influence you have. Because many people look upon the local teacher there. They believe you know. You know, I remember when I was in primary school, none of us had shoes. None of us had underwear. Lakini mwalimu mtoto mwalimu alikuwa na kiatu na hapo nane. Because mwalimu hapo na mshahara hata kama si mingi, it is assured. And the only people who would get credit in the local trade camp, nobody can give them any credit because they are not likely to pay. Yes, energy and other stakeholders will discuss your issues. You can do for me a memorandum on the issues that you think you want us to address. I'll convene all the stakeholders. pia mimi napenda kukaa na watu wamesoma. Najua somo yangu iko chini kidogo. And you know, those of you who taught us biology, concentration to
Diana. I'm from Nyamira County.
Thank you. My name is Benjamin Mwatine from Kitui County. I have not seen my director, so he's somewhere down the road. So, ladies and gentlemen, our research is titled Integrity on Trial. That the integrity of this country in national examination has been on trial because it has had a lot of loopholes. And we intended to unveil the perspectives on cheating in the KCSE examination 2023, and it is our research paper dated 25th June 2024. Let's move forward. This research report focuses on the perspectives of secondary school heads in Kenya regarding cheating during the KCSE examination. In the background of this research is the growing concerns about the integrity of national examination. Is there integrity or not? The methodology we used was a mixed approach, the quantitative and the qualitative data collection, which implied on the need for motivated interventions to uphold academic integrity. That's the word. In our introduction, this lessons, in our introduction, this action-based research delves into the perspective of secondary school principals on the current mechanisms and the motivations behind the cheating in KCSE examinations, if there was cheating. Why? What is the motivation behind cheating? And our demographics, our survey included the following. 276 sub-county schools responded to our questionnaire, forming 67.48%. 70 responded from the county schools, forming 17.11%. And 52 responded from extra county schools, forming 12.71%. And 9 national schools, which formed 2.20%. In the experience of the teachers who responded, we have 81 principals who responded who have served as principals for 5 years or less, 120 principals who have served for over 15 years as principals, and 110 principals who have served between 6 to 10 years as principals, and 95 principals who have served between 11 and 15 years in the position of principal. In terms of gender respondents, 65% of those who responded, principals were male, and 35% of those who responded were female. And the answer we are trying to answer in this research is, was there cheating in the KCSE 2023? In our survey, 96% of the respondents answered that question with the answer yes, and 4% answered no. So you can compare the data of yes against no. And they say in the research that data does not cheat. So, what is our perception on the integrity? The person operating the slide, can you keep on moving, please, because of the delegates? So the person was there cheating in KCSE in 2023, 96% of the respondents says yes, and only 4% said no. You have your own response. What is the perception of the integrity of principals? their beliefs on cheating KCSE exam is what we are trying to interrogate. Now, in our methodology in the interview, this questionnaire encompasses a series of structured questions which we had and a normative report which was procured from select members of the National Governing Council. And in our research, we got the following data on how cheating happened in KCSE 2023. One, there was collusion and complicity. Two, there was use of unauthorized materials in examination rooms. Three, there was bribery and corruption, where invigilators, supervisors, security officers were bribed to allow exam cheating. Four, examination materials leaked. There was examination material leakage. Five, there was technology aided cheating, and so forth. Now we also had another question on why are schools cheating in KCSE. Reason number one that we were given is pressure to perform well from the stakeholders, from the TSC, from the ministry, and from the politicians and other stakeholders. Reason number two, fear for failure. What will become of me when my school fails? Number three, to increase enrollment and get more funding from the Minister of Education and from the parents. And number four, the desire for recognition by Teachers Service Commission. Number five, lack of preparedness by the candidates. Six, political influence and abetment, where some politicians are demanding for results by hook or group methods from their schools which they are funding through CDF. Next was the moral and ethical decline. Moral and ethical decline in the society, in all the stakeholders that are participating in the KCSE, ranging from the supervisors, in the legislators, the police officers, the principals, students, etc. And the laxity in the supervision and the government and action in the whole process of monitoring to ensure fair examination and administration. We therefore combine the data in the proposed measures that could end examination cheating. MS. The recurring theme from the responses is the need for policy and administrative changes, particularly the call for the Teacher Service Commission to stop promotions based on performance and to stop issuing principals letters due to poor performance. That is why some principals who have spent a lot of money to get the results have been promoted, but the TSC has never asked how did these people get these results. That is where we discuss and saw certain principals when they leave certain schools, those results are never realized again. Success rate on collecting twice in a day. What result did we get on this? It was moderately successful to collect exams twice in a day, and 159 principals concurred on the effectiveness of that. And 126 principals said that there is no change from previous measures, whether we collect twice or once, the status quo on cheating continues. And 82 principals, forming 20%, said that the collection of exams twice in a day was not successful. And 41 principals, forming 10%, they said that the collection of exams twice a day was very successful. Remember, we are getting data from these gentlemen and ladies. It is not our money. What about the use of secondary school teachers as individual teachers? How effective was it? That principles strongly agreed that it is effective to use secondary school teachers as individual teachers, forming 7.33%. 62 principals forming 15.16% agreed that using secondary school teachers as individual letters was effective. 48 principals were neutral on using the teachers of secondary, that forming 11.74%. 119 principals disagree on the effectiveness of secondary school teachers managing KCSC, forming 29.09%, and 133 principals strongly disagree on the use of secondary school teachers in invigilating the exam, forming 36.67%, which is the highest percentage in the data. What about the perspective on secondary school teachers, on the support for secondary school teachers and others individual letters? Number one, secondary school teachers, why we argue that they are the right people is that they have a better understanding of their high school students they are managing. Secondary school teachers could be more assertive and effectively control candidates due to their regular interaction with them. Competition among schools might make secondary school teachers more committed to preventing cheating. What about the perspective on secondary school teachers continued? More points. When we opposed, those who opposed the secondary school teachers individually, they said they are easily compromised to assist in teaching, especially in their subject of specialization. They facilitate cheating due to their familiarity with the exam content. Competitive pressure and unhealthy competition was seen as factor that could lead to cheating practices. Systematic issues such as exam leads and collisions with the center managers were highlighted as challenges that might not be addressed by changing individuals. Emotional intelligence and the ability to understand student behavior. Advice that you provided on this included the following topics. One, systematic and administrative reforms, operational changes, punitive measures, cultural and perception shifts, education policy changes, integrity and accountability, and technological and procedural setbacks. Number one recommendation, NEC should be made an independent body. We propose a restructuring of the Kenya National Examination Council to operate independently for the following rationale, in that independence ensures unbiased examination processes and minimizes external influence. Recommendation number two, enhance security and monitoring. We suggested that one, jamming of mobile phone signals to prevent communication during the examination school, rotating invigilators, this reduces familiarity and potential collision. Three, CCTV cameras, monitor examination halls and deter malpractices. Then on policy and administration changes, we proposed the following. One, stop school ranking. This ensures elimination of pressure to manipulate the results because of being desiring to be ranked on the top two. Change the promotion criteria by focusing on the holistic student development, this needed to end the political interference and should examination from political agenda. On educational and ethical reforms, we emphasize on the following: one, proper preparation. Let us encourage better study and not shortcuts in preparing for the examination and getting results. Two, continuous assessment. There should be a shift focus from final examinations so that we have a hybrid between the final examination and the continuous assessment. Three, promotional integrity. Promote integrity. Instill honesty and ethical behavior. Recommendation number five, advocacy. There should be heavy punishment, possibly sack and even imprison those involved in exam cheating. Recommendation number six, resource allocation. We recommended one, we have a needs-based funding that we allocate resources based on the school needs, not just on enrollment or numbers. Two, staffing improvement. Ensure adequate staffing for effective candidate preparation. On technological solutions, we get the following ideas. One, we should embrace on online examinations with the password, which is where we shall securely administer exams online. Two, phone detectors. We prevent mobile phone use during the examination. And in our conclusion, we say the following. More research needs to be undertaken to confirm or disconfirm this research and expand the scope to include education officers, teachers, students, and parents. This research was compiled by Abdi Ismail, our chair, myself, Esther Wabugu, Mugatana, Mary Luvanda, Liz Anam, Mohammed Isaac, and Dorothy Bunti. I wish to recognize my team leader who was unwell, but he has gotten stronger. He has come. Please take over from me. Let's welcome him.
Thank you very much. I think there is a next slide. We wanted you to also help us get some more information.